Nzi Wetegu was at Devon. Ask us if we can do a MGD logo. I love architectural, structural designs, and I thought let's try one. Nzi, have a look at this and let me know your thoughts. We do have 3 or 4 videos that will help you with the design of other ways you could do the MGD. But I thought let's do a structural architectural video on this channel. Join me. For our design, we're going to be using a nice big canvas to have a nice big space for this one. We're going to press T and we're going to be using a MGD logo. So I just want to see this MGD when I'm busy designing. You could also do the same just to help you along. I've used a box font just to give me a guideline because I want to do an architectural structural logo for this one. That's why I'm using a boxed one to guide me with the design that I have. The first thing you're going to do for your design is you're going to press L for a line, and then with your L you're going to size your L. We're going to make our points rounded for this one, and we're going to make it a little bit big, like a 25. And then with our line, we are going to go to our shapes and we're going to pick a square, or you could press R for a rectangle to create a square. So we want the structure to be completely aligned and to be the same size. So that is very important with a structural kind of a design, because you want it to be aligned and to be the same size with all your letters. So make sure you have your sizes to the T. So you could make any size you want, but it must be the same size. Otherwise, it's going to look bare. Then you're going to move it and over to your line or your structure, so that we are now creating our 3 letters so that they are completely the same size. So the first one would be my M, and I've created that. I'm happy. I'm going to just make changes and give it a nice black color. You could make any color you want. I'm going to duplicate this for the second letter, which is the G, and I'm going to duplicate that for the third letter. See, Canva knows that I want to make everything aligned. So looking at the first line, this side and this side, it tells me that they're not the same size, so I need them to be the exact same size. Next, we're going to duplicate our line and we bring it to the bottom of the page. We zoom in and we create our structure. Next, we're going to duplicate our line again, rotate it. Next, you're going to start creating your letters to create your gorgeous design. So we're going to duplicate the shape and we're going to be creating our M with this one. And we're going to create our G. Okay, last thing, we need to get rid of the M, and we're gonna press R for rectangle so that we get a white rectangle. We change it to white, we rotate it, and we start aligning it on top of our M over here to create that beautiful gap that we want, which is should be the same size as the other side of our design. So I'm gonna just reduce this. Then we're going to click on position and send it to backward. Now it's sent to our backward. We're going to click on our line. We click on position, we send it to forward so that it slices it and it looks like that. Adjust it nicely so that it's not cropping into our design, and align it ever so gently so that it is same as the other side of our design. Pretty sharp, hey? MGD. I'm going to delete this MGD. You're welcome to write the name of the company on top or at the bottom. And I'm going to download it as a transparent background. Remember, we still have that white line over there. So we need to upload it back on Canva and then remove the background. So we're going to download it as a PNG and as a transparent background, and we click on download. What you would then do is you're going to add it back on Canva so that you are able to remove the background of your design. You are more than welcome to add an extra page and then upload it to your canvas and then remove the background. That white, that's the white we want to take off from our design. So we're going to click on edit image and we're going to remove the background. Again, if you don't have remove background and you want to trial it for 30 days, go to my link on the description below and try it. My favorite part would be to convert it to 3D. So you're going to access www.photopea.com and we're going to click on templates and we're going to select mockups and we're going to find that nice steel-like mockup that we can use. The one that says stainless steel logo mockup, you open it and you click on the link done by Graphics Family. Once it's loaded, you're going to double click where it says your logo here. And this is how it should look like, or the sizing that you should have on your 2D. You're going to click on the eye to hide the example. Then you click and you drag your design. Then you size it and align it. Then you press Command S or Control S on Windows to change it to Smart Object. And then you click on your first tab to view your design. And there's your design. Still like MGD, stunning. If you enjoy these video tutorials, please support the channel either by buying one of our courses and learning more on Canva by going to learnwithzar.com and buying one of our courses. Other than that, we do have two or three videos that I'm going to link on the description above that you can go and learn and see how you can make a three-letter logo look stunning using Canva. Thank you for joining me on this tutorial. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I hope you have a wonderful day. I'll see you on the next video.